Hello.
Stitches, I'm Dimple Anand and I'm very glad to welcome you on Stitching Morning. Today, we'll learn to make a straight pants.
These are beautiful straight fit pants with elastic. You don't need to make any zipper or side pockets or anything. And you can mix and match them with long shirts, kurti, top, tunic. And these are really nice, comfortable and good fit. I used cotton fabric. But if you use a more sturdier fabric, it would give you a very pant-like look, like that your formal pants. And these are very easy to make. I'm sure you'd love to make them. I took the fabric widthwise, so I took about 2 meter fabric. But if you take fabric lengthwise, you need to take 2 meter plus 5 inches. Sometimes when it's a plain fabric, it's not easy to identify the back side and front side. For easy identification, we mark it. Before laying the fabric, we wash it and we press it and then we lay it. We mark 1 inch away from the folded side. The length is full length minus belt. Belt width, that is 1.5 inch plus 1/2 inch, so that would be about 39 inch. Later on we'll take about 1.5 inch for bottom. So mark straight horizontal line on top, then mark the hip length, that is 10.5 inch, hip divided by 3 minus belt length. Mark hip line, that is hip divided by 3, that is 12 inch, and square it up, the same 12 inch. And here we make a box, come 2 inch inside, mark and join these markings. Mark hip divided by 6 or 6 inches up, make it a small curve in the corner, and now shape front hip curve. Go 4 inches inside on hip line and make a straight line till bottom. This we had taken full length minus belt width plus 1/2 inch. Here we'll make our bottom and we'll make a straight line. Across this straight line we'll mark, each side we'll mark 3 inch, that would be bottom divided by 4. Leg length is midpoint and 2 inches up. Mark 2 inches up to the middle length, middle point of the leg length. Extend this line. If you want knee fitting, then mark knee divided by 4, that will be 3.5 inches each side of this line. Now using a straight scale, you can join the bottom knee with hip mark. If you want to give it a shape, then you can use the leg curve or you can mark it straight. You can do it freehand also. Using this leg curve, these things used for sewing and cutting, these are very easily available and economical, so you can get them. I take 1 inch out for seams both sides. Bottom you can keep 1.5 inch down or 4 inch as you have the fabric and your own choice. Now we cut the outline. Here we had 1 inch and from here we had marked 1 inch out. Both the sides we had 1 inch seam allowance. We'll cut on that. Jeans is a very elastic fabric, that denim is an elastic fabric, so we don't need seam allowance in that. But if you use any other fabric, you'll need to have seam allowance. Cut from the up, that straight line, and the hip curve, and the sides, and don't forget to make the notches, because they'd help you when you'll be stitching. And keep bottom fold 1.5 inch or till 4 inch. I'm keeping it about 1.5 inch. Extra fabric you can cut, make notches. Now our front part is cut. Keeping this front part, we'll cut the back part. Same method. Lay the fabric. This fabric is pre-washed. I've shrunk it, keeping in water for 2-3 hours, and then dried, and then ironed, and then your fabric is ready to be cut. So I lay this front part on back part, fold it, mark 1.5 inch inside and 1.5 inch up. And here I take this midpoint and mark. From inside you mark, make a this join it, make a straight this line, slanting line, and from here I take 1.5 inch. Later on we'll join the this back hip curve, but right now we join this waistline a little bit slanting. We take 2 inch out from hip line and shape the back hip curve. If there is any wrong line or guiding line, you just erase or cut it. Otherwise, at the time of cutting, you may spoil the fabric. Mark 1 inch out from knee and bottom. And the other side also. Other side also, take 1/2 inch seam allowance from the other side. Sometimes we don't take this side seam allowance because the other one, the hip line side, is covered in that. But here we are taking it because I cut the fabric widthwise. And widthwise fabric is a little bit, it gives you a less give while sitting. So you need to have a little bit more seam. So I cut the back part also, cut the side, Now we cut the belt. This is 3.5 inch wide and length would be same as your waist, half of waist plus 5 inch. So here in our case it is 19 inch. So 3.5 inch is the width. Fabric is folded. Half of waist plus 5 inch, and we cut it. This is a simple belt, and elastic. This is 1 inch wide, and it should be as long as the waist that minus 1 inch, that is 28 is our waist, so I take it take it 1 inch less. Sometimes the elastic is more loose, it is more stretchable. In that case, you can keep it a few inches, like 3-4 inches less. Now we stitch these straight pants. First of all, we'll stitch the hip curves. Front parts with the front, back parts with the back hip curves. So stitch them. It's easy, simple. Hold the side of this middle stitch is done, hip curve. Then we open it, keep right sides inside and back sides outsides, and we stitch the side. Now we stitch the belt with the waist. For this, we hold back sides of the fabric out and right sides inside. Holding from one side, we make a simple stitch and join both the pieces. Fold the belt and stitch on the corner. Again, start till the finish. You can use the other method of inserting the elastic shown in my earlier pajama and straight cut pant making. You can check that out, because in pajamas I've shown in detail how to insert the elastic the other way. But this is also one of the ways which you can use, and it is a simpler way also. Insert the elastic using a pin and bring out this elastic from the other corner. Spread the elastic evenly, or you can do one thing, spread it in such a way that the front is flat and the back you have those wrinkles of the elastic, and then you can make a parallel stitch on this elastic. Sometimes we gain weight or lose weight very drastically, or we make these kind of straight pants or pajamas for the kids. In that case, you can leave extra elastic in the sides and make a side stitch and close it, and then fold this elastic and using a button loop it in the sides. So you can loose this pajama pants anytime you want. Now we make a straight stitch on the side, and then we'll be stitching fork of the legs. Now stitch fork of the legs or middle of this pajama pants. So starting from one bottom of the leg, middle and till the other bottom. So here the notches would help you match front part with the back side. See, now if you want this crotch area to be lesser, you can make a stitch here. And if you want this leg to be narrower, you can make one parallel stitch here also. Whatever changes you want to do, you can do that to your own dresses. Cut the extra threads, and this elastic either you can cut or in the sides you can loop them with a button. So whenever you require, you can loose it. You can make a top stitch if you want. Now we fold the bottom. We had made notches and we had also marked, so it is easier for us. We can fold it inside, pin it, and then we can stitch it. Just like formal pants, these straight pants are very comfortable like a pajama, but they look very formal and good fit, ready-made looking nice pajama pants, and I'm sure you'd like wearing them. They're very nice to wear. I made them for myself, and that's why I can tell you that this is the right way to make them. If you want to add zipper or side pockets or back pockets, patch pockets to it, you can do that watching my other videos. The videos I made for jeans pocket or zipper or patch pockets. But you can use those kind of same method for any kind of pajama pants or plazos or skirts or pants to make those patch pockets, zipper, and those side pockets in any of these kind of lower dresses. So fold the other bottom also, and our pajama pants, these straight pants would be ready. You can team them up with any kind of dress, like your short shirts, tunics, tops, kurtis, long kurtis. They look very beautiful, very nice, and the fitting they give is really very formal, nice one. You can give a side slit also. If you want, you can use a side zipper in the sides. The way I've shown how to make slits in a skirt, long skirt, in one of my videos, the same way you can make slits even in these pants. So here you can keep an opening of about 4 or 5 inches, and bottom fold you can keep longer. I hope you enjoyed making
straight pants with me. So do share, comment. If you didn't subscribe yet, do subscribe and like. So goodbye and keep watching. I'll be